Hi, in this tutorial I will create an Arduino control library. So the contents of this tutorial: short introduction to Arduino. Then this control library will contain a PI controller, a mathematical model of a given process, a low pass filter, and then these three features will contain the main parts of the control system. So we will use Arduino to create this control system. So step number one is to just to create and make this control system work. So we will create a Arduino code for the PI controller, a mathematical model, and the low pass filter, and do some simulation to see if it works as expected. Then the next step is to improve the code structure, make a class, improve the functions, use local variables instead of global variables, etc. And then finally, when we have made this work, we will take the next and final step to make an Arduino library. First, a short introduction. So we will create a basic control system using Arduino. In this tutorial I will use Arduino Uno, but you can use other Arduino devices if you prefer. We will create a simple PI controller. We will implement and create a mathematical model, which we will simulate and control using this PI controller. We will also implement a low pass filter, because this control library can be used to control real processes. So then we need to use a low pass filter in order to remove noise from the measured value. When all this is working properly, we will finally create an Arduino library. And by creating an Arduino library, it makes it easy to reuse your code in different applications, and it also makes it easy to distribute the code to others. So here you see the basic Arduino control system that we are going to create. We are going to create a PI controller that are going to control this process, or a mathematical model in this case. And then we will create a basic low pass filter that removes noise from the process. Typically we don't need a low pass filter, just using a mathematical model, but this Arduino control system, or the Arduino control library, are also meant to control the real process, and then typically we need to use a low pass filter in order to remove noise from the measured value. So then we have the reference value, the filtered measurement value. And then we find the error between the reference value, or the set point, and the measured value. And then based on the control algorithm, the PI controller, this one will calculate a proper control signal that are sent to the process, or the mathematical model in this case. So we will create this Arduino control system and the Arduino control library in three steps. Step number one, just to create and make the control system work. Then we will improve the code structure and make a class, and improve the functions using local variables instead of global variables, etc. And also improve in general the code and the functions. And then finally we will make this Arduino library. So step number one has already been made in another tutorial called Arduino Control System. You also find a video for this tutorial on YouTube, but we will also have a short repetition on this step number one in this tutorial as well. So then let's get started. We start with the Arduino platform. So Arduino is an open source electronic platform based on easy to use hardware and software. It's intended for anyone making interactive projects, from kids to grown-ups. And you can connect different types of sensors, like temperature sensors. You can control a process, like we are going to do in this tutorial, etc. And it's typically used a lot in Internet of Things projects. You find more about Arduino and the Arduino platform and the different Arduino boards on their homepage. So here you see the Arduino Uno that we are going to use in this tutorial. Arduino Uno is the most used Arduino boards. It's easy, just plug in the board using a USB cable to your computer, and then you're up and running. And the next step is just to install the Arduino programming environment, which you see here. and you can download it for free from the Arduino webpage. Then let's start with the PI controller. So here you see the algorithm of the general PID controller, but typically we don't use this derivative part of the PID controller so much. So typically in most cases we only need a PI controller, which consists of the proportional part and the integral part. And then we have the tuning parameters in this PI controller, this KP, which is a proportional gain, and then TI, which is the integral time. And then we have the E, which is the reference value or the set point value, minus the process value. Because we are going to implement this algorithm in the Arduino software, we need to make a discrete version of the PI controller. So based on this general equation of the PI controller, we can find the derivative on both sides, and then we'll get this equation. And then we can use, for instance, Euler backward discretization method in order to find a discrete version of this PI controller. So then we end up with this basic equation that we can easily implement in the Arduino software. So here you see an example how this PI controller can be implemented in Arduino software. So I have made a separate function called PI controller, and then inside this function I have implemented this equation for the discrete PI controller. Typically also need some variables, so I have, in this basic example I have just defined all the variables as global variables on top of my Arduino software program. Next let's go to the process or the mathematical model of this process. So in this tutorial I will use a what I call an air heater system. This is a small scale industrial process used at the university, and the aim of this system is to control the temperature on the outlet here by controlling the heater element here at this at the beginning of this tube, and then air is flowing inside here and out here. So basically we are going to control this temperature on a given set point by controlling the heater element on the input here. I will not go into too much details regarding this air heater process, but it can be made a mathematical model of this process by this differential equation. And as for the PI controller, we need to make a discrete version of this equation. So we use also here the Euler approximation method. So we apply the Euler approximation method on this equation, and then we end up with the following discrete equation of this air heater system. And this is the equation we are going to implement in the Arduino software. And also some problem with this air heater system, it has a time delay because the air goes in here and it's heated up here, and then it flows through the tube, and then on the output here we are reading the temperature. So there's a time delay from here when we read the measurement value here. So it contains a time delay, but just for make it simple, we just ignore this time delay and set it to zero in this case. So then we get this basic equation that we can implement in the Arduino programming environment. So here you see an implementation of this air heater model in Arduino software. So here we have just made a function called air heater model, and then we have implemented this equation inside this function. I also established some variables, and in this basic example I've just put all the variables on top of my Arduino program as so-called global variables. Next, let's take a close look at the low-pass filter. So as mentioned, we use a low-pass filter in order to remove noise from the measurement signal. So here is the basic equation or the transfer function for a low-pass filter. And then based on this one and using so-called inverse Laplace, we can find the differential equation. And when we have a differential equation, we can use the Euler approximation method in order to find a discrete low-pass filter. So then we end up with this equation, which is the equation for the discrete low-pass filter, which you can easily implement in the Arduino software. And here you see our Arduino implementation of the low-pass filter. So we have made a function called low-pass filter, and then I have implemented this equation for the discrete low-pass filter. In addition, we need some variables, and in this basic example, I've just created some variables on top of my program as so-called global variables. So now we have made the PI controller, we have made the mathematical model and the low-pass filter, and now we are ready to combine these things into the first step of this control system. So here you see the control system. We have made this PI controller in Arduino, we have made the mathematical model in Arduino, and we have made this filter in the Arduino software. So then we end up with the following code structure in Arduino. So on top we have some initialization. So here I put all my variables. Here in the void setup, here I can also put some initialization. But here in the loop, this is the main program. Here I have put the PI controller function, the process model function, and the low pass filter function. And then at the end I have a delay, and then this goes into a loop until I plug out the power of the Arduino device. And here you see the final result. So here you see the entire implementation of the Arduino control system. On top I have variables, the setup, I write the output of the process to the serial plotter as you see here, and then we have the main program here with the PI controller, air heater model, and low pass filter, and I also made a function for plotting to the serial plotter. So basically this is the main program, and here you see the final results. And as you see, in this case I have set the set point to be 24 degrees Celsius, and you see it starts here and then it goes up and stays on the set point value. So this proves that this control system works as expected. So now I have opened the Arduino programming environment as you see here, and also have made this basic Arduino control system. Here on top I have some variables for the simulation, here I have some variables for the air heater model. Here I have some variables for the control system like the KP, TI, the reference value, etc. And here I also have some variables for the filter, the low pass filter. And here in the setup I start the communication with the serial plotter. And here in the main loop I have put in the function for the PI controller, the air heater model, low pass filter, and the serial plotter. Those functions are defined here in the bottom. Here I have the function for the PI controller. Here I have the function for the air heater model. This is the function for the low pass filter, etc. So now I can just click here to upload this application to the Arduino hardware. So I just click on the upload button. And then when it's finished uploaded, I can go to the serial plotter to see the actual simulation of this Arduino control system. And as you see here, the reference value was set to 24 degrees Celsius, and the initial value was 21.5 degrees Celsius. And then you see the output of the process, the temperature in this so-called air heater system. And as you see, the controller are able to control and put the process on the given set point, which is 24 degrees Celsius. So as you see, the control system works as expected. So let's summarize the development of this Arduino control system so far. So we have made a simple control system with Arduino, and as you just saw, it was working as expected. But the code examples are very simplified and lots of improvements can be made. We can typically reduce the use of global variables, etc. We can also improve the code structure and put the code into and the functions into a class. And then finally, we can also make an Arduino library to make a more general control library that can be used by you in other applications or by other persons. So let's get started. So now let's take the next step. We will make a class and then improve the code structure. So here you see a part of the code. I have put or created a class called control, and then I have made a constructor. I have put the different functions into the class, the air heater model, the PI controller, the low pass filter, and the serial plotter. And I also improved the code structure. I have removed most of my global variables. I have put and used local variables inside each function, and then also have returned, used a return value. So now this air heater model return the process value. The PI controller return the controller value. The low pass filter return the filtered measured value, etc. So basically, this code has a lot better structure than the previous example. And here you see the main application that are actually using this class. So I need some variables on top. Then I define or use this class and creating an instance of this class. So this is the object of this class. And then I need this instance of this class in my application. So in the setup, I start the communication with the serial port and the serial plotter. I define some initial values. So I define a simulation time, TS, which is 0.1 in this example, 0.1 seconds. And then I have defined a controller parameters, the KP and the TI, and then finally the reference value. And then here in the main loop, I'm using this object, which is this instance of this class. So I just use control dot and the name of the function, which is PI controller, which is defined in the class here. And now I have using a return value. So the output of this function is the control signal, and the same for the air heater model, which has an input U, the control signal, and the output is the temperature value. And the same for the low pass filter. The input is the raw measured value, and the output is the filtered measured value. So basically, and finally also I re-plot the output of the process to the serial plotter. So basically this is the main program, which is actually using this class, which I have defined here on top of my application. So here you see the entire application created in the Arduino programming environment, and also here I have the simulation of this system, this control system. And as you see, it goes to the reference value, which is 24 degrees Celsius in this case. So also as you see here, the control system works as expected. So now I'm back in the Arduino programming environment. Here to the left, we have the previous program where I have made lots of global variables on top. Here's the main loop, the PI controller function, air heater model function, low pass filter function, etc. And now here's the new version of my system. So here on top, I have made this class, which goes down here. Here. So here the entire class, which contain some variables, which is set to public in this case. I have this class constructor, which you find here. I have the different functions for the air heater model, which has an input value and a return value. I have the PI controller function here, which has an input value or an argument and a return value, and the same for the low pass filter, etc. And then on the top, I have defined this class, and here the main program starts. Here I need to have some variables, etc. I define an initial value for the process variable, this temperature value. I have the simulation time, the start value for the controller, etc. And then we have the setup, start the communication with the serial plotter, and also define KP and TI, which is the controller tuning parameters, and have the reference value, which is 24 degrees Celsius in this case. And then I have the main loop, where I have this instance of this control class. So then, since all these functions are part of the class, I need to first put the name of the object or the instance, dot, and the name of the function. So control.pi controller, control.airheaterModel, and control.lowpassfilter, etc. So basically, this is the main program that are actually using this class I have created on top of my application. So let's just run this example. I click on the upload button, and when the program is uploaded, we can start the serial plotter. So now it's uploaded, and I start the serial plotter, and as you see, this was the initial value, and then after some time it goes, and the process value goes to the given set point, which is 24 degrees Celsius in this case. So as you see here as well, this improved control system still work as expected. So now we are ready to take the next step, which is making an Arduino library of our example. So libraries are basically a collection of code that makes it easy for you to connect to sensors and other types of modules. In general, it's just a collection of code that can help you solve a specific problem. So this means that you don't need to make everything from scratch. You can use one of the thousands of pre-made Arduino libraries that you can use for different purposes. So there are hundreds, probably thousands of different additional libraries that other persons has made that you can download from the internet. But you can also create your own libraries from scratch, and that's what you are going to do here. So why are we going to create this library? It gives a better code structure. You can easier reuse your code in different applications. And also it makes it easy to distribute your code to others. You find more information about how to make an Arduino library at this webpage. So basically, in order to make an Arduino library, you need to create two different files, one so-called header files, which has the extension .h. And then we need to have the source file, which has the extension .cpp for C++. So basically, when creating an Arduino library, you use C and C++. And this file contains the functions within the class. And note that the library name, the folder name, the .h file, and the .cpp file all need to have the same name. And these files need to be put into a specific location on your hard drive. You can change the location, but default location is for Windows on the C drive, users, and your username, documents, Arduino, and libraries. So I have already made this Arduino library, so let's take a closer look at the details. So now I'm in my location here, on my hard drive, users, my username, documents, and Arduino, and then I find this libraries folder. I double click on this one, you find all the libraries that you have installed on your computer. And also here I have put my library, which I have called control. And as you see here, it contains of this file, this header file, called control.h, and then we have the file that contains the functions itself, this control.cpp, and also you can have a readme file if you want to, and also a keywords file that you can use to improve the way your code is appearing in the Arduino programming environment. But let's focus on the header file and the CPP file, and also on the examples. So you can also have a separate folder called examples where you put different examples how to use this library. But let's start to open this control H and the control CPP. I prefer to open it and use this Visual Code Editor. So I just right click and open in code. And then this file is open in Visual Code. And the same for the control CPP, open in code. So then I have these two files here. Let's start with the control.h. So in order to create such an Arduino library, you need to follow some strict rules. On top, you can have some comments or information about the library. Then you need to include those two lines. You need to include the main Arduino.h header file, and then you start creating the definition of your class, which is here. And finally, you need to have this end if statement at the end. But this is the main, this here is just something you need to have, while this is the definition of your class, which I have called control. And then you can have some public variables and public functions, and then you can have some private variables and private functions. So here on public, I have defined some variables, I have the constructor, and I have my functions, the air heater model, the PI controller, low pass filter, and the serial plotter function. And also have made some private variables, which are private and can only be used within this control class. So that's the definition. We have defined all the variables and define the different functions. So this is the header file. And then let's go to the control.cpp file, which contains the actual implementation of the functions. Also here on top, I need to include the Arduino.h and then this control.h file here on top. Also here on top, you can have some comments and information about the file. Then you start creating the constructor if you need one. And then you define the different functions. So here is the function for the air heater model, which you have seen previously. Here is the function for the PI controller. Here is the function for the low pass filter. And here finally is the function for this serial plotter. So this class contains of these four functions. And by since you're going to create an Arduino library, we need to put it into this header file and this CPP file. So now we have these two files. And now next we should create an example where we show how we can use this library. So then I have created an examples folder, and inside here I have created an example called control underscore system underscore example. So I made this folder with this name, and also within this folder I have made the Arduino file itself, which needs to have the same name as the folder. So control underscore system underscore x dot ino. So let's also open this example in the Visual Code Editor. And then you have it here. And then on top, you need to include this control H file, which is here. On top, you typically have some initial values and variables. Then I have the calling or making an instance of this class by creating this object called control, which we are using here in the main setup function. So I specify the simulation time, the KP, TI, and the reference value. And in the main loop, I just define and call and execute these different functions that are now defined in this control.cpp. So we have the function for the PI controller, air heater model, and the low pass filter and the serial plotter. And all these functions are now defined in this control CPP. And I have defined this instance of this class, so then I have to have this include this control dot and the name of the functions like this. And now we have made the entire Arduino control library. Let's see how this looks like when you open the Arduino programming environment. So now let's just open the Arduino programming environment. So here you see the Arduino programming environment, and here under file I can go now to examples, and then down here you see all the libraries that has been installed on my computer, and then we have examples from custom libraries, and then you find my control library, and you also find my example. So I can basically just click on this example to open it, and then the example we just saw pops up, and then basically we can just run this example. Also, as you see, the example includes this control.header file, which is the library file, have some initial variables and values, the setup function, and the main loop. So let's just click on the upload button, and then when the program has been uploaded to my Arduino hardware, I can open this serial plotter. And the same here, the starts on an initial value, and the reference value is still 24 degrees Celsius. And as you see here, we get the same results as in the previous examples. So this proves that I have made this Arduino control library, and it works as expected. And after some time, it goes into the set point, which is 24 degrees Celsius. So when creating an Arduino library, you should always also create one or more examples that shows how you can use the library. And also here you see the example that is part of the library. But also, if you are going to create your own program, you can just click File New, and then under Sketch, you can click or find Include Library. Here you see the overview of all the libraries that has been installed on my computer, and then I find the control library. I just click on this one, and then you see this control H has been included automatically, and then you're ready to start creating your own application based on this library. Also, if you want to use an existing library, you can go to Tools, Manage Libraries, and then this library manager will pop up, and here you see existing libraries that has been created by others, and then you can download those one or more of these libraries by clicking on the install button. So, and you can search for a category, you can search for a specific name, etc. So that's the next step. If you are happy with your Arduino library that you have made, and you think other persons can use it, and then you can make sure to install your library so it's part of this library manager. So that makes it very easy for others to just search for your library and then install it. So let's summarize. So you're creating your Arduino libraries, and then you need to put your files into this library's location, on this location on your hard drive. And then the name of the library, which is in my case the control. And in this folder you need to create this header file, the CPP file, and an examples folder. And you can also include these keywords and the README file. And then when you have done that, you find the examples here in the Arduino environment, programming environment, and file, examples, and control in this case, and the name of, here you can have one or more examples. And if you need to use the library, you can, as mentioned, go to the sketch, include library, and find the library name. And then this header file will be included in your code. And as mentioned, you find examples here under examples. And when creating the Arduino library, you need to create this header file, which is the definition of the variables and the different functions, and then this main CPP file that contains the code for the different functions. And then finally, you should create one or more examples that shows how to use your library. And as you see in this case, the Arduino control library, which has made in this tutorial, works as expected. And if you are, as mentioned, happy with your library, you can make sure it's included in the library manager as shown. So here you see the library manager. If you want to have your library as part of the library manager, you can go into this web page and find out how to do that. But that's not part of this tutorial. So thank you, and good luck with your Arduino libraries, and thank you.